a cowboy down in Texas, and a western Superman to save the cowboy down in Texas.
Tonight we tell another tall tale from the American frontier. So you all have heard the story of Paul Bunyan, the giant from North Country, and John Henry, the man who hit his hammer and was able to beat the machine. But this is an altogether different story. It's about a man who seemed in touch with the man in gray, in ways beyond imagination. He was almost like the Superman of the Wild West. But before I can tell you about him, I suppose I should introduce myself. My name is Devin Connel, Devin Jasper Connel, and I am the assistant of Seth Lewis at the Fireside Tales. I do my best. I will admit I'm a little bit clumsy and nervous around people, but, you know, I try. And while Seth was on vacation, he wanted me to tell you all a story. And, you know, I was like, well, what would you like me to tell it about? And he said, well, they all seem to like American fables. So I couldn't think of any American fable greater than Peco Bill. That's my own personal opinion. So I'd love to share his story with you, an altogether true story, as outrageous as it may seem. But anyways, it all begins in Texas, where a family had 18 children, 18 of the most rowdy children that you could imagine. They were always biting each other and hollering, and the family just, the parents at least, they had enough. They decided that they were going to take him on a trip. So they loaded them all up and they started heading out. And as they were riding along, they hit a bump. And little Bill, he fell out and landed down on the ground. And he was stranded out there. Now, as it just so happens, he was stranded by the Peco River. And that's how he gets his name, Peco Bill. But anyways, as he was sitting there and he was crying, a group of coyotes came up to him. And I'm pretty sure Peco Bill was very frightened at that point. But as it so happens, they took a liking to him. Maybe they saw him as one of his own, the way he would bite and holler at things. And they ended up raising him. Underneath the stars, all those days would pass. And Peco Bill learned the way of the coyote. And one day, Peco Bill's brother happened to come by. And he happened to be looking for him. The whole family had been looking for him for quite a few years now. And when he saw him, Peco Bill was just sort of sniffing around and biting at his own leg. And his brother came up to him and he said to him that he was a man. But Peco Bill refused to believe that. He wasn't as well-dressed as them or as snobbish. But his brother continued to insist and, you know, Peco Bill wasn't going to hear it. But finally his brother pointed out that he didn't have a tail. And all of the other coyotes had tails. So Peco Bill looked down at his rear end and realized that was true. And at that moment, he knew that he was in fact a human. Well, he decided he'd go into town, and he got himself a nice suit, and he decided he was going to be the King of Texas. So soon enough, his legend was known far and wide of how rowdy of a fellow he was. He would eat dynamite, and he got himself two snakes, a rattlesnake and just this little small snake. The small snake he would use as a whip, but the big snake he would use as a lasso, and he'd throw it around in the air, and he'd catch himself whatever happened to be coming by, cows or whatever. And he also had two steeds, his horse, Widowmaker, and a mountain lion, which took a little bit of, coaxing in order to get him on his side. I mean, mountain lions aren't exactly known for wanting to be ridden, for someone, you know, to put a saddle on him and start riding him around. But they ended up becoming good friends. And one day, a big cyclone came through the desert. And Peco Bill was walking around, and he realized that if that cyclone hit the town, it would destroy all those people. So he got his lasso out and he threw it around that cyclone and he got on top of it and he started riding around, bouncing around. And it didn't really seem to bother him much. He just took up a cigarette and started smoking it. Well, eventually it got all out of breath and it just sort of dispersed all around and Peco Bill landed on the ground and he managed to tame that cyclone. But another day he was out by the river and he was fishing with Widowmaker. And as he looked out, he saw this woman on the back of this giant catfish, and he thought to himself that she was the most beautiful woman in the world. And he would continue to go down to the river every day to see her, and finally ended up getting her to come close, and he was a little nervous, he didn't know how to talk to her. But eventually, the two became fast friends, and from being fast friends, they became, well, they fell in love. And they would sit out under the stars every night, and Peco Bill would pull out his gun, and for her, he would shoot off all the stars. He'd shoot out all their lights, until finally only one would be left, which would be known as the Lone Star. Well, they were so much in love with each other that they finally decided to get married. And it was a beautiful ceremony, and a very odd ceremony, too, with a mountain lion and Paul Bunyan sitting nearby, and just all sorts of weird creatures. A whole family of coyotes, as well as a whole family of humans, which, well, were obviously very nervous of the coyotes. But anyways, as Peco Bill was putting his wife down on the back of Widowmaker, Widowmaker started bucking, and he continued to buck and buck. And Peco Bill couldn't figure out why. But the truth was that Widowmaker was a little bit jealous of his wife. And he bucked and he bucked, and he ended up bucking so much that he bucked her right off his back. And she flew up into the air, and she landed on the moon. Well, Peco looked around, and he finally found his lasso, and he started throwing it up in the air, and he threw it up, and he caught her right there on the moon, and he started to pull her down. But the thing was that she was bouncing around now so much that she just couldn't stop. And although it hurt him to do it, after a few months, he finally shot her to put her out of her misery. Well, anyways, Peco Bill never married after that, and he never talked to Widowmaker again. His heart was too broken, even though Widowmaker apologized profusely, never mean for things to get out of hand. But that's the way it is in the Wild West, and I suppose we'll just have to leave off on a rather sad ending. But it is another great story for the American Fable. And I suppose I have some things to do. I'm gonna go and organize some books, I guess. I hope Seth's back very soon. I'm not sure if I'll be able to do this too much. I'm really just not good about talking with people. Maybe I'd have a better time with coyotes. Sometimes, if public speaking, I think I would. I'll see y'all.